हेलो, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल गेन जावा नॉलेज। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज प्रोफाइल्स इन स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशन एंड हाउ टू यूज प्रोफाइल्स इन स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशन। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट एंड डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज प्रोफाइल्स इन स्प्रिंग बूट। एज वी नो, टुडे इन एवरी एंटरप्राइज एप्लीकेशन हैज मैनी एनवायरमेंट्स लाइक डेव, क्यूए एंड प्रोडक्शन। सो ईच एनवायरमेंट रिक्वायर ए कॉन्फिग्रेशन दैट इज स्पेसिफिक टू दैम। सो दिस एनवायरमेंट होस्ट स्पेसिफिक कॉन्फिग्रेशन कॉल्ड प्रोफाइल्स। सो टूडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न हाउ टू क्रिएट स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोफाइल्स एंड हाउ टू यूज दिस प्रोफाइल्स इन स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशन। सो फर्स्ट आई विल क्रिएट वन स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोजेक्ट। सो हेयर आई विल टाइप स्टार्ट डॉट स्प्रिंग डॉट आईओ and here I will just define the artifact id spring profile boot profiles example, and here we also need to add dependency. So here I will just add one dependency, that is spring web, because in this project I will create just single rest endpoint. So here I have generated. Now here I will go to Eclipse and here I will just import the Spring Boot project, existing Maven project, and click on finish. So in this example I will show you how to use profiles to control loading of different files and different configurations. So here we can see project is imported successfully, and here just created one single class, that is the main class Spring Boot application. And now what we need to do, we just need to create one REST endpoint. So here I will create one more package and we'll create one controller class. So here I will just define dot controller package and we'll define the class, and the class will be like message controller finish. And here I will just add the annotation, that is at the rate rest controller. And here I will create one rest endpoint. Public string get message, and this rest endpoint will read the message from our property file and will return the message. So here I will just use at the rate get mapping and define the URL, and here I will use annotation, that is at the rate value. And here we'll use dollar sign, and here I will just print my message, and so this will read the message from property file and will return from this endpoint. So here I have just created one REST endpoint. Now what I will do, here I will go and here we will check our application dot property files already created, but it's empty, and we can create more profiles. This is simple profile, and if you want to create more profile, here I will click and create new application dot property files, and these are the extensions that we need to use while creating our profiles. First we need to define application, then hyphen, then our profile name, that will be dev, production, testing, anything can be here. And there will be the extension like .properties or .yml, we can use anyone. So here we are using .properties. So here I will create one more property file. First I will copy it and paste it, and here I will use hyphen that is the naming convention that we need to follow. Application dot dev properties, and if you want to create one more, so here I will copy and paste here, so it will be like test. Now here we can see we have created three profiles: application dot property, application dev properties, and application test properties. These are specific to each environment. So here what we need to do, first we need to go here application.properties file, and here we need to define spring.profiles.active, which one we want to use. So here I will just type dev, so dev profiles will be active. And here what we need to do, here I will go to message controller and copy this string value and go to my default property file. If there will be no property file will be activated, then by default it will read from here message default user welcome. And now I will copy this message. Now I will go to dev environment, and here dev user. Now I will go to test environment, welcome test user. So what I need to do here, first I will run this application, and we can also provide the port name to specific environment. For example, if I want to define port number for our dev environment, that is 8080, and we can use 8081. And for our testing environment, if you want to specify different port number, so we can define here like 9090. So now I will run this application and we'll check our profiles are working fine or not. So first I will run as Java application. So here we can see in the logs our dev profile is activated. The following profile are active is dev, and port number used in 8081. That we can check here, our dev profile is activated because in our default application.property file we have defined spring.profiles active is equal to dev, and these are the naming convention that we need to follow while defining profile names. So now I will go to browser, and here I will type localhost 8081 message. So here we will check welcome dev user, the message was printed, and this message we have defined here in our application.dev properties file. If I will remove this from here, and we'll run this application again by stop the server. So here we can check again, now our default properties file will be activated. So here we can see on the console, no active profile set, falling back to default profile, that is default profile, and port is default port, that is 8080. So here I will call from the port number 8080, and here we can see welcome default user message was printed that we have defined in application.properties file. And if you want to activate test property file, then what we need to do here, we need to define spring profile active is equal to test, then our test profile will be activated. When our test profile will be activated, our application dot properties profile always be activated. But if same values and same properties that we have defined here and also defined in application dot properties, these will override the default properties value. So now I will run and check the logs. So here we can see The following profiles are active, that is test profile is activated and port number is 9090, that we can check here. Port number 9090 and the message will be welcome test user. So I will go to browser and here I will just call 9090 port number and we'll check the message. So here we can see welcome test user is activated. So like this we can do, and there is one more feature that is supported by Spring Boot profiles. Like this, if we want to define configuration file, so here I will create one config file, and programmatically we can also control profiles. So here I will create app config, and here I will create one new package, that is config package. And in this config package I will just define the annotation, that is add the configuration, and here I will just create one method, that is public void print some value. So here I will just print some value, that is sysout welcome to my channel gain Java knowledge. And here I will define the annotation, that is at the rate post construct, that is spring bean lifecycle method. So it will be execute after creating the bean of each class. And here I will just define annotation, that is at the rate profile annotation. So it will control if here I will define the profile name test, it will be execute only when if our test profile is activated. Means in our default application dot properties, if our active file is test, active profile is test, then only this class will be execute. So now our application dot property file is using the test profile. So this class also execute and this will be print on the console. Now I will stop this application, stop, and we'll rerun this application and we will check the output on the console. Run as Java application, and here we can see welcome to my channel gain Java knowledge has printed because our test profile was activated. And here what we did, here we just define the profile is test. So this configuration file will be activated when we are using test profile. If I will use here no test, then this profile and this configuration will not be activated. It will be activated if we are using any other environment like dev production here, then this will be activated. So if I will run this again, now this will not printed. So now I will stop it again and rerun this application and check the output on console. Now we can see the output will not printed here. So here we can see this time welcome to gain Java knowledge channel was not printed because here we have defined no test. If our profile is no test, then only it will print. So here what we'll do, here I will just change dev. Here I have activated dev profile. Now we will check it again. Now this message will be printed on console because this is not related to test. So run this application again and check it here. Here we can see welcome to my channel gain Java knowledge has printed. So these are the main features of Spring Boot profiles and how we can control, we have seen here. Okay, thanks for watching this video.